And now a museum exhibition created by designers and brain researchers that challenges our senses by demonstrating how we all experience art differently. Jeffrey Brown reports from Dallas as part of our ongoing Arts and Culture series, Canvas.
It's a kind of playground inside an art museum. Large room-sized works in which exploring the different ways each of us experiences the world around us is as important as the art itself. Now at the Dallas Museum of Art, the exhibition is titled Speechless, Different by Design. It's unusual in that touching and much more is encouraged, even required.
I became interested in what happens if we do an exhibition where it's interactive, where we encourage people to use all their senses.
Unusual, too, in how it began, in a very personal way for curator Sarah Schluening, when her now six-year-old son, Vaughn, was first diagnosed with an expressive language disorder.
Speechless is really quite literal in that he was speechless for the first several years of his life. And as we were navigating that as a family, we were trying to figure out, I'm a hyperverbal person, and what happens when the words that I use and how I express and communicate is no longer valid. And I think that led me into these ideas of what is disability? What does that mean? I didn't think he was different. His sister doesn't think he's different, but he gets out in the world and people didn't know how to communicate with him, and it was very frustrating.
And that led her to also rethink her work as a curator and how we all interact in different ways with art. For this exhibition, she asked artist designers to bring those differences to life. Eni Archibong, a California-born, Switzerland-based designer, created an installation titled The Oracle. It's made up of 10 pill-shaped synthesizers crafted of blown glass.
Like you can feel, right, the vibrations in the room.
Museum visitors can move them, subtly altering the sounds in the room, even the color and vibrations of a pool of water. The console controlling all this, Wizard of Oz-like, is behind a wall. Yuri Suzuki, Tokyo-born and London-based, created Sound of the Earth Chapter 2, a large sphere that requires the visitor to experience it up close. Suzuki gathered audio by crowdsourcing on Instagram, with people around the world sending in clips of sounds of everyday life. Here, sound substitutes for visual imagery we might expect in a work of art.
And if I stay here long enough, I'm gonna...
Yeah, then you'll get a nice, we get sort of a hug.
Yeah, yeah.
Most playful of all, Misha Khan, a Brooklyn-based artist and furniture designer who filled a large room with strangely shaped sacks of hand-painted silk over vinyl, each covering a wood sculpture inside. And all of it constantly inflating and deflating, so the whole room seems to be breathing.
Everything's touchable and you can kind of explore it. And for me, I wanted to find a way to sort of embed these sculptures and humanize them by having them breathe and sort of shy away from you.
Not only that, you can jump in and take a seat, and so we did.
Because sitting is the idea here, right?
Yeah, well, I think...
I mean, experiencing it.
Yeah.
You wanted to know if this would be perceived as a place to sit?
Yeah, and then, like, if you sort of think of it as a chair, then what else is going on? And so it sort of pulls you into a different area. It activates your brain in a slightly different way.
Challenging to find that central sulcus on everybody.
And that is what Dan Krawczyk brought to the exhibition. Krawczyk is a brain researcher and deputy director of the Center for Brain Health at the University of Texas, Dallas.
We're essentially seeing how active the brain is. It's a heat map of areas that are particularly active for some kind of process.
In 2018, before the artists got to work, curator Sarah Schluening brought them together with scientists and medical researchers who study brain function, autism and dementia, and much more. Dan Krawczyk was one of them.
I was excited by the possibility because we don't often have these opportunities to have a science meets art kind of conversation. And I have long thought that especially visual arts has a very clear link within the brain. And when you're a neuroscientist, you tend to always think, how does the brain become active in these different ways?
Yeah. The artists then did their thing. The design team of brothers Stephen and William Ladd created this room from hundreds of rolled up, colorful scrolls of all sizes, each made and initialed by a resident of Dallas or Atlanta. The room entices the visitor to touch and feel, or sit and meditate. Neuroscientist Krozik was able to explain to the artists how their work alters perceptions.
I think that the major message I try to inform them about is how dynamic the brain is, that we don't just perceive, we're constantly perceiving with a goal to act. And the brain is constantly cycling between perceiving and then acting. And so I thought there was a lot of exciting synergy with the way the brain really works, because we always want to take the next action.
Why would this kind of art be more accessible to someone who we would call disabled in terms of what's going on in the brain?
It's changing the inputs pretty dramatically, right? Mm-hmm. And that's going to change the brain state quite dramatically. So the range of options, if you're more of a touch-based exploratory person, you're likely to get something very different out of these exhibits.
And that, of course, is the point of this exhibition, which even includes a so-called de-escalation room where visitors can relax with a weighted blanket after all the sensory stimulation. Curator Sarah Schluning hopes the exhibition can be part of a new model for museums.
When we can offer experiences and opportunities that may change the way that they see and perceive what art is, what a great thing to be, to not be locked in a box. It's okay to be different in the space, and you still can be surrounded and engaged in the experience.
The exhibition Speechless, Different by Design was a collaboration with the High Museum of Art in Atlanta and travels there next. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown at the Dallas Museum of Art.